Excel Live is a new addition to Teams. It changes the way you share and collaborate in a Teams meeting. Not all meetings need to have a presenter and a passive audience setup. Some meetings call for full-on collaboration, working live in an Excel file. Here's how it works. If you've ever interacted in an Excel spreadsheet with your colleagues, you know this can be quite a pain. Real-time collaboration in Excel often results in syncing conflicts and multiple versions of the same file. So I was quite excited when Microsoft finally announced Excel Live, essentially embedding Excel in Teams. This way, anyone in the meeting can edit and explore content within the meeting window. So here I am attending an exciting finance session, and the presenter decides to use Excel Live. Now, I'm a bit shocked and surprised about this new setting because on the bottom, there is something that says following Chris. This basically means I don't have to follow him. I could do other stuff in the file. So I'm just clicking over to test data and I'm changing some numbers. And on the bottom, it says resume following Chris. And the moment I select that, I can see where he is and what he's talking about. And here's the best part. I get to zoom in as much as I want. And we know that this can be a problem when others are presenting Excel files. They usually are so zoomed out, you can hardly see anything. But this way, you're in full control of the Excel file. You can do anything you want here. You can adjust the numbers. You could even filter the data set and create your own sheet view. So here, I go to the View tab, and I want to filter stuff, but I don't want to affect the other people's view. So I'm going to go and select New. This is going to create a new sheet view. Now I can filter as I need. So let's say I'm only interested in Arizona and Florida. I have filtered this, but other people don't see this. It's a specific view. So I'm just going to give my initials for that. And now I'm going to see where Chris is. Let's go and resume following him. And I can see Chris is actually on the same page, but he's not seeing the filter view. He's seeing the default view, which is great. So all the filtering that I'm doing on this sheet isn't affecting the other people who are using this. Now let me show you how things work from the presenter side, how you can use this as a presenter. So when you're in a meeting, go to Share, and right underneath PowerPoint Live, you are going to see Excel Live. You get to see some of your files. If you find that one there, you can just select it. If not, browse OneDrive or browse and look for the file on your computer. You can click on Show More, and then finally, when you have your file, just select it, and then you're going to get this pop-up that you are going to be ending up sharing the file with all participants. If you're okay with that, click on Share. Now you are sharing your file live in the meeting. This means that others can navigate and edit the workbook without ever leaving the meeting screen. And because this is using Excel and the web technology, you don't even need to have Excel installed on your computer to be able to contribute here. So yeah, this is not great for everything because sometimes you obviously don't want the people to mess up your content, but it's great if you're collaborating on a project. It's great if you're giving a small corporate training and you can create separate tabs for each people and get them to do some tasks, right? So you can get really creative with this. Whenever you're done and you want to close your session, just click on Stop Sharing, and this closes Excel Live. Before we wrap up, let me tell you some of the requirements and limitations of Excel Live. So this feature is currently still in beta. This means that you need to turn on public preview in your team. So if you click on this dots here on the side, go to About, you have to have public preview on. And if you don't see this option, that's because your IT has disabled this for you. So if you're on good terms with them and you can get them to change their mind, you can tell them to turn this feature on for you. Once you add a check mark there, you have to come and check for updates and get the new updates installed, and then you should have it. The other requirement is that the workbook you want to collaborate on has to be stored on OneDrive or SharePoint. Excel Live is also only supported for meetings with up to 25 people of the same organization. And also, currently Excel Live meeting recordings are audio only and won't include video of the interactive workbook. Okay, so keep that in mind for now when you're using Excel Live.
I'm curious what your thoughts are on this new feature. Is it something you can use at work?
comment below, let me know. Thank you for being here. Thank you for watching. Subscribe if you aren't subscribed yet. And I'm going to see you in the next video.